was quite challenging to decide to start our own business in the middle of the financial crisis.
Yes.
And I mean, we really didn't have any money. My name is Olof, Gardarsdottir, and I'm a graphic designer.
My name is Hildur, Sigurdardottir, and I'm a graphic designer. We started Reykjavik Letterpress in 2010.
Also, everything today happens on the screen. You can read the newspaper on the screen, online, and you can, you know, invite people to your party online. You can have your to-do lists on your phone, and you do everything. You don't need the paper, but it still makes. But you still need the paper, because if you work on watching the screen all day, it's a relief to grab a book, you know, in your hand, instead of constantly being on the screen.
So now we try printing
again. Yeah, see how it goes. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Nei, Birna, það er hérna. Mm. Veistu hvað þetta er?
Hlýtur að vera klysið að finna það jafnt hér.
Já, það meira blek.
En hún ekkert brotin eða neitt, þetta mjög sko. Já.
Þetta
klysið? Já, þetta something with a klysið.
It's all about the base.
It's all about the base. There we go.
Nice. Very fine.
One of the first projects we did was an invitation for my wedding. And then very quickly we learned the challenges to design for letterpress printing, because that's not the same as designing for other more conventional kind of printing, because we only print one color at a time, and well, I have a Danish husband, so I want to make one in Icelandic and another version in Danish, and you know, that's two different. Well, it took us a long time. We had three colors on each, and yes, so we very quickly learned that how to think about the printing method when we're designing for.
We found an ad online of a small print shop being for sale. And there was this old printer.
He was 84 at the time.
Yeah.
He's 90 now.
Yeah. And he'd been working from his garage for many years, for decades. With all these things, but they had the movable type and this machine and the paper cutter and all the small the drill and all kinds of stuff that we.
So Olaf found this ad online and it had a list of things that were included. And in between there was this Heidelberg machine. So we saw that machine on the list and said to each other, yeah, okay, we'll call him and we'll only buy the Heidelberg machine and not none of the other stuff. And we decided to visit him, and then immediately fell in love with him and his machine.
And it was very challenging to learn to start it for the first time. And for the first 2 months after we decided to buy his machines, we got to go practice in his garage with him.
Yeah, he found it very fascinating that we were going to go for this.
Maybe we'd never done it if the financial crisis hadn't happened. Because we had more time on our hands. There were less projects at work, so more time to surf the internet and find some beautiful things online. And every time that something letterpress came up, the heart skipped a beat. You know, it was just, this is so beautiful. Why don't they do this here?